Hey guys, welcome back to another video. Today I'm back in Roblox Ultimate Driving. Today I'm going to be showing you guys how you guys can make the most amount of profit in this game. I have a kind of a new method. It's not really new, it's just because really all the it's kind of same to the old method, like it's just a rework to the old method, just so you don't get bored as easily. But I do want to tell you guys that, and as well as the old method, so let's just get straight into it. Also guys, make sure you guys go ahead, join my Discord server, link in the description. I will be on here doing streams and whatnot, and you guys can even join and play with me while I'm making a video. If you want, if you join my server, I'll put out a notification letting you guys know I'm recording, who wants to join me. No one's joining me right now because this is a tutorial video, so I don't really want people joining me currently, but alright, so the first thing you're gonna need to do is hop in your dealership and look for the car that has the most amount of money possible that you can make per mile. Okay, so I'm gonna head over to the garage here, and you're gonna pick your car. So everyone starts off with the basic cheap car, which is this car here. So if you have this car, it is the only car you can really use. I think there's a one other free car, you can use that. If you did however play during like whenever they were giving out free cars, such as this one, which is the best, I would recommend this as a really good grinding car. As well, these two here, I mean, this is pretty much like I wouldn't really use that, but there's a bunch of other free cars that you could have claimed when they were doing events and stuff, like this car, this car. So I would recommend you guys to use these cars if you have them, but if you did not, then you're gonna have to just use the basic free car that you get for starting off. Alright, so I'm gonna use my best car. I mean, it's not the bestest car in the game, but it's the best one I currently have. I'm saving up for a better car. Alright, so first things first, let's head over to the place, and everyone's probably already gonna know what I'm about to say, because I'm about to tell you guys to just run down this highway here, go back and forth all the way through it. So that's the first step, or that's one way. Or the next method is to actually drive from, I'm pretty sure, yeah, you can go here, drive here and come this way, hop on this highway, take the exit here, come through here and run through this back road here, and make your way all the way back to Westover. Those are the two methods. So I like doing this other method because it's not as boring to drive back and forth straight down. But there is a couple drawbacks with this method. I mean, you will find more people driving down these roads. There's more turns, meaning you have to slow down a lot, and yeah, you can crash easily, as well as I'll show you guys what I mean when I get there. But the other thing is, first let me just show you this race here, or I'm sorry, this path here. I'm just gonna tell you guys what to do when you get there. There's actually something you should do which will make it easier, or just allow you to make the most amount of money as well as XP. And I do see a lot of people forgetting to do this when they're grinding. Alright, so let me just quickly head over there and I'll see you guys then. Alright guys, I'm back. I'm just now pulling up to the spot here. So as you guys will see here, it's right here at the edge of the highway by Bordenville. Obviously this is a whole other game. You can play this game if you want, but everyone goes to Westover just because of this long road to grind. So when you reach at the end here, you're gonna see this race here. Now this is what people forget to do. You can actually go in here and race by yourself. Now you're not gonna get money. You don't get money at all for doing races, but you do get XP. So I will do the I-76 Nam Tonk race. Basically, this will take you all the way around to this end right up here. The race that's right up here, or I'm sorry, the checkpoint that's right all the way up here, it's gonna take you there. And from this checkpoint, you can race all the way back by yourself to this checkpoint. So it's pretty easy to do. It takes about 2 to 3 minutes, depending on your car and how fast you're. Your skill. It doesn't take that long. And also, the payouts you get depends on the car you have. So this car here will give me, I'm pretty sure it's like 940 or 980. I don't 100% remember how much it gives you per mile, but that's how much I get per mile. So in on average, I make about 10,000 a race doing this. So that's about, I'm just gonna give it 10,000 every 3 minutes, right? So let's say I make 10,000 every 3 minutes. So we know if I were to sit here for an hour, I would be doing these races 20 times. So 20 times 10,000. So I can make $200,000 every hour with the specific car. So make sure you guys do the maths with your car to actually determine how much you're gonna make. And that also gives you a bunch of XP. Now, if you have a friend with you who wants to race with you, you and him, you guys can race together. And by racing with someone else, you will get way more XP than racing by yourself, okay? So that is this race here. Make sure you guys do your maths on your car to determine how much money you can make in an hour and determine if this method is the best for you. I'm gonna head on over to Westover, where is where I like to start doing this other method. And I'm gonna time myself and see how long it takes me to actually complete this loop that I told you guys. This is the second loop. Now with the second loop, you can't really do the races. I mean, you can do it if you want. You can race from here all the way to Kensington, and then race from Kensington to Woodbury, and then Woodbury to Westover. But then you have to go this way, or you could have gone this way if you wanted, but I guess you could do that, but I just think it's just a hassle to have to stop at each spot to do the races. So I just like drive straight through them. Anyways, okay, so as I'm racing down to Westover, I do want to mention a couple of tips real quick. If you have boost on your car, this is pretty much, I make a 987 a mile, so I just confirmed that. Alright, so if you have boost on your car, I recommend to actually boost right off the start. Now you guys are like, that obviously you would do that, but why am I telling you this? Because I normally would boost downhill, but I don't, it usually goes way faster when you're going downhill, but I think these new chassis, it doesn't do that anymore. So you automatically go faster anyways. So with these new chassis, is you can reach max speed. Let me just do it real here, show you guys, you can reach max speed without even boosting. As you can see, I'm gonna go 220 when this car can only go 217. And if I boost, let me just try to boost real quick. See that? It doesn't barely do anything. Like, it doesn't even do anything. I'm not sure. It just accelerates your car faster. That's all it does. Alright guys, I'm here at Westover. Honestly, the race took me way longer than I would like. I don't know if I must have clicked the wrong race then. Alright, so pretty much you're gonna start like right here, okay? And you're gonna make your way again to Palm Shores, all the way down to the end of Palm Shores right here, down into this highway. Do not go down to South Beach unless you want to make like a turn here for whatever reason, but just head on this highway and make your way straight down here. Take the exit into Kensington, then come straight down here, come into Woodbury, come all the way around the edge here, and go back into Westover and just make that loop. So I'm gonna time myself and also see how much money I make. Starting amount, okay, I can't type for some reason. All right, and then we could do end and then time. Alright guys, I'm back and I'm just about finishing up my run here. As you guys can see, I am now about to pull into Westover and we're about to see how long that took me. Right? Here we go, we're back in Westover. So that took me about 3 minutes and 30 seconds to complete. Alright, so we started with this amount of money. We're now only at 830,126. Alright, so let me do some quick calculations here and we will figure out how much we actually have here. $6,629. So, with my specific car, I only made $6,600. Not a whole lot, actually. That's actually pretty low compared to doing the main highway run. And the reason that it, obviously the path is much smaller. Like, it looks pretty big, but it's actually not really. It's like, it's probably about half of this highway run. So in about 3 minutes, I managed to do that to get 6 minutes or 6,000. Is it worth that 3 minutes? I would say yes, it's kind of worth it if you don't want to get bored easily. If you're down to getting bored easily, you're going to do the highway run. Now, if you're going to do the highway run or any of these, I do want to give you guys a couple of tips and advice as what to do, because obviously you're going to get bored to grind. You can put on some music, obviously go to Spotify, put on your favorite playlist, or just join my Discord server and go to the music channel here. I have two of them, and you guys can listen to music there with other people. Or here's the best thing here. If you go ahead and head over to this Chrome extension called Floating for YouTube, I'll possibly have a link in the description if I remember, or I'll probably just have it in my Discord. I always have like all helpful links in my Discord server, so make sure you guys join that. But just get it right here. It's called Floating for YouTube. It'll also install here, but after you've installed it, click Launch App, and basically it'll pop up like this, and you're gonna just find a YouTube video you want to watch and paste it in here. Alright guys, so I just found one of my videos. I'm gonna paste it in here, and it's just gonna start playing just like this. I'm just gonna turn that volume up. Alright, so as you guys can see, I can just skip around on here and play. Alright, so now I can hit straight back to Roblox, and it's right here. I can hit into my Roblox game, and I can play and watch YouTube, and you can watch any YouTube video you want. It could be a live stream or anything. It doesn't have to just be a video. And you can move it around. So this icon right here, just move it. You can scale it how big and small you want it. I just keep it about this size. Yeah, it's pretty much what you could do with this. It's really, really helpful for grinding, is you don't really need to, you know, just focus in on your game, just focus on something else. Now, I will say the second method does require you a little bit more attention and focus to the road so you don't miss turns. But for now, guys, thank you guys for watching. Please hit like on the video. Make sure you guys join my Discord server. A giveaway will be happening pretty soon here on the Discord server. And also like this video and make sure you guys subscribe.